This video presentation is a production of batches 81 to 85 of the Subdominant 7 in celebration of its Silver Jubilee anniversary in the year of our Lord 2006. With hearts full of gratitude to those who have supported us all through those years and to those who have sustained the flame of service through music, our younger members of the Subdom family, to all of you, we offer the Subdominant 7, our story. Out of the Oblate Seminary sometime in 1980, one of the pillars of the Subdominant 7, a junior Oblate of Mary Immaculate or Jomai, moved to Ateneo de Davao to finish college. His name is Marcelo Sota Jr. and we fondly call him Toto. Everything in his new environment was so exciting. Big city, the most reputable school in Mindanao, new faces, new teachers, new academic challenges. Yes, everything, except for the old wooden dilapidated chapel located at the old CM Recto entrance. And with that, were the boring masses attended by a handful of students and teachers and worsened by the stench smell of a nearby bakery. How could the Ateneo live out what should have been the center edifice of the campus? In his early days in the Ateneo, the chapel has become his refuge and tambayan. And as an idealist ex-seminarian, he thought he had a responsibility to use the little talent he has in playing the guitar and leading the singing. It wasn't that difficult for him though, as he had with him two other ex-Jomais, Gilbert Hadrake and Ramon Nalugon. Toto then relates that Gilbert and Ramon's stories were similar to his. They shared the same passion to make the celebration of the Eucharist lively so as to encourage the community to join and actively participate. These three formed the nucleus of those who regularly attended the Mass in that old chapel every afternoon. It was sometime in August of 1981 that a group of students, together with a religious studies teacher, sat down on a long bench right at the spot where the old campus ministry office was located, just right in front of the old chapel, and talked about organizing themselves to form the chapel choir. Among others, this group included Ms. Reina Acerios, the RS teacher, Lorna Lau, Elsa Fernando, Juan Araceli, Ramon, Gilbert, and Toto. It was at this time that the Ateneo College Chapel Choir was formally organized, with Ms. Acerios as the moderator and Toto as the chairman. However, even before this formal organization, other young, active first and second year students were already joining the nucleus and performing other tasks, such as preparing the things needed for the Mass, reading, singing, and even cleaning. Most of these younger students later joined the group, which blossomed into a very closely knit family, while sadly, most of the original organizing members did not have that much time together, as everyone else were very busy with other activities. The Ateneo College Chapel Choir, as it was called, commenced to formally tend to the requirements of the daily afternoon masses. Sometime in the summer of 1982, we had our first seminar on the basics of music. We had as our speaker Sister Narcisa Fernandez, one of the very famous composers of liturgical hymns at that time. It was there that we first heard about the subdominant 7 chord, which was presented together with a key and the dominant chords. The subdominant 7 chord struck most of us, leading us to reflect on this particular guitar chord. Through God's enlightenment, it then dawned on us that subdominant 7 has more significance in the singing ministry that we are in. It was then decided that from Ateneo College Chapel Choir, the club's name be changed to a more meaningful and catchy Subdominant 7. So why subdominant 7? If you play the key of C, the dominant chord is F, and the subdominant chord is G. Before going back to the key, which is C, we usually put it in 7th, the subdominant 7, which in this case is G7, to make a better transition. What then is its significance to us? The key is Christ, as manifested in the celebration of the Holy Eucharist, and to which we are all invited. It should never be put a second priority in a student's life, for He is our inspiration, and participating in the daily masses keeps us strong. The dominant chord is our studies, as this is, on the first place, the reason of our existence in the Ateneo. But study should not be in contravention to the development of our spiritual life. It should, in fact, be a part of our total development. The subdominant 7th chord is us, the subdomers, who commit our time and dedication to be the bridge of other students to the key, which is the Holy Eucharist. The 7th chord makes a smooth and harmonious transition back to the key, just as we, through our singing ministry, makes a lively and meaningful celebration of the Mass so that others will find meaning in it too. Thus, our mission, to serve as the bridge between the students and the celebration of the Holy Eucharist by making the Mass lively and meaningful through our songs. In God's grace, after a year, the chapel was never the same as before, as it was now teeming with people eager to join in the Eucharistic celebration. Later on, a new chapel was built, so timely so it could cater to the growing number of Mass goers. God's work never fails. We intensified our ministry and developed more awareness of the liturgical hymns through our annual concert dubbed as the Agape. Agape meaning love. As subdomers, our offering of songs, of music, is a manifestation of God's love shared to the community. Much more, the focus of our ministry, which is the celebration of the Eucharist, is also called Agape. Aside from the business meetings we had, which were held outside at the open space near the new chapel or the campus ministry office, we also hold dear in our hearts the memories of our outings, Christmas caroling, visit to the Maa City Jail together with the late Father Finster, recollections and retreats, and our involvement in the various activities of the school, such as prayer rallies, university days, graduations, and every Eucharistic celebration in school. Toto was the first one to leave the group in 1983, after his graduation. Gilbert assumed chairmanship of Subdominant 7 for a year, as he graduated in 1984. In the infancy of Subdominant 7, the group was made up mostly of those who graduated in 1985. First-year students then, during the organization's birth, some already active at that time. As we left the portals of the Ateneo, we believe we made ourselves more relevant in the lives of the students through what we do best and for God's glory.